Music is like magic. It is everywhere. At parties, at church services, and on city streets, we are apt to hear music. Fundamentally, though, what is music? Yes, it can be a blend of vocals, instrumentals, rhythm and/or melody, etc. But it is also something much more. It is connected to us in ways that elicit positive changes in our mood and well-being. There's a profusion of studies to back this up. It can heal in a supernatural way, not just the average individual, but also the mentally ill. Music, in short, is the elixir for all mankind. Let it always be our doctor when we are unwell. Let music be forever what American poet Henry Wadsworth Longfellow called the universal language of mankind. There's many types and genres of music, too many, in fact, to name. Suffice to say, most, if not all, music has the potential power to lift us up out of a cold and dark, downhearted place. Music can even be a tremendously uplifting catalyst for people afflicted by a mental illness. In one study published by the American Music Therapy Association on schizophrenia and psychopathology, it showed that characteristic symptoms of schizophrenia were greatly reduced in just 3 months by implementing what's known as music therapy. Music therapy sessions involved the performing of music, listening to music, or discussing music. It is loosely used to address physical, emotional, cognitive, and/or social needs. Performing or listening to music, as is recognized scientifically, activates many structures in the brain that are involved in thinking, sensation, movement, and emotion. Once the structures are activated, neurotransmitters are released, producing emotional reactions, memories, and feelings. Simply put, music moves us. The creator of sound, a magician. In another study showing music's meritorious wizardry, a group of people were told to read a list of words and then recall them by memory. Half of the group had been selected to listen to classical music while reading the words. The other half were not. The results showed that those who were given music to listen to had an easier time memorizing the words. Music is poetry. Each song a separate poem. Music is also within us and without us. It can change perspectives. It can transform lives. I can't imagine trying to live life without music. What a nightmare. But to think of the universe as an assiduous musician at work, we are the waves of electric vibrational energy resonating through time. All time and space, a turbulent yet beautifully sacred synchronistical symphony.
On the spot.
Welcome.
Yeah.
Sadly, this is our last episode of season one. As the fall comes around, you know, I'm heading off to college, so this is the end of an era. We're gonna have to. Who knows if there'll be more episodes? You'll have to wait and find out. But today, it's all about today. We've got a great episode for you. You know, I was thinking.
Yeah.
This morning, I woke up to the sun. Mm. Sleeping with the windows open. Something I've been trying.
Yeah.
I used to go camping all the time.
Oh, you're a big camper.
Yeah, big camper.
I love camping. I just went camping.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And I haven't been camping in a long time.
Yeah.
And the windows open. It's like camping. Just in your house. It's just like camping. Think about it. Just the noise of the outside, and you're going
to
sleep.
My bed is right next to a window, and I always have that open.
I got...
Always.
Like, my bed's like here. I have a window shining here and over there.
Oh, yeah.
When the moon's just right, it's nice. It's just like a nice... It's just outside at night in the summer, it's just better.
Ooh, that's pretty.
Yeah.
Dude, I'll even do that in the winter. I'll even just put that in
the
right
window.
Oh, yeah. Hey,
calm down.
You can't. It's too cooped up.
Hey, you like the window, you don't like the window.
Like, what are
you
doing? For like in 6 months.
Yeah, but like in the winter, it's cold.
Yeah. That's good for sleeping. You get that heavy blanket, you know, and then that window that's open. It's a perfect balance.
No, then you wake up in the morning and you have like a cold and you like have pneumonia. Like,
you got pneumonia. I don't got pneumonia.
I don't know. Well, you know what? I don't have pneumonia because I don't open my windows in the winter.
So. Everything's stuck together. You just
it's like frozen. Yeah, that's what happens.
Just gonna let the window open.
You know,
I don't deal with that. What about you, man? Do you leave your window open?
Yeah, of course I leave my window open.
Let's Seamus. Yeah, we all remember Seamus. Yeah, he's back.
Yeah.
Hey.
Again, back again. Back. All right.
Yeah, shout out to Seamus.
Yeah, Seamus.
Wow. Less soloing this time, hopefully. Yeah.
So you leave the window open?
Yeah, of course, you know.
Duh.
I don't know. It's the air is really nice in Massachusetts. You can't really like I lived in Texas, the air was just so dry here. It's,
oh, really?
It's nice and humid, you
know.
Yeah.
Does it smell different? I know each place has a different smell.
Yeah, Massachusetts smells way worse. Just everyone up here, the people.
Oh, the people.
People smell?
The outside.
I've heard New Jersey smells.
See, I believe that.
Oh, New Jersey.
Like people say they like drive across the border and it's just like
open.
You can't say that.
You can't say that, Joey.
I just said it. Sorry.
On my TV, Joey.
It is. It smells like a toilet. How about that?
No, I've never been.
With the seat
You've
open.
Never been in New Jersey.
Never been in New Jersey.
I drove through it, and that's all I needed.
I might have driven through it, but I didn't go outside, so.
I opened the window.
You opened the window?
That was a mistake.
Yeah. But
smell like doo-doo.
You know, I don't want to judge New Jersey too much. I think that New Jersey has...
I will.
I don't know what they have. What do they got?
Smell like doo-doo.
Like Bruce Springsteen.
She's from New Jersey?
I think so.
Really?
New Jersey seems...
I don't believe it.
It doesn't seem like he's from New Jersey, but I swear I've heard that before.
We'll get our fact checkers on it.
The team, the on-the-spot team.
Yeah, the on-the-spot team. yeah, I don't know. Bruce Springsteen is not from New Jersey. There's no way.
I don't even like the guy.
You don't like Bruce Springsteen?
Nah.
I mean, he's all right.
Nah, he isn't.
I've recently had an awakening. Not the Bruce Springsteen. That's just how he sings. It's character.
It's character. Get the character.
My mom loves Bruce Springsteen, and she loves like 80s pop.
I don't want to. I respect him, but no thanks.
But like my mom listens to 80s pop all the time, and then like I never liked it. But I've recently had an awakening to like, it's, I don't know,
no,
like post-disco.
Post-disco?
Like, disco?
Yeah, but it's like post-disco.
I'm about to leave.
It's like Michael Jackson, Off the Wall. The album's so good. I love the album.
Is Michael Jackson post-disco?
Off the Wall is.
Yeah, he's got a little disco in him.
Yeah, he has just enough disco. That's the thing.
Huh.
But like Bee Gees, I love Bee Gees. I mean, they're actually like more like actual disco.
Yeah, you can't not like the Bee Gees. Bee Gees.
But yeah, stuff like
I can't
that.
Think and play.
Like, dude, Dua Lipa, bro, that's such a gifter.
No.
I will defend Dua Lipa.
We're talking about
you go from Michael Jackson
disco?
To Dua Lipa.
Yes,
Michael Jackson. Dua Lipa out the window.
No. Dua Lipa, great.
Get out of town.
Great.
Great at what?
Disco. She's the modern Michael Jackson. Okay.
Whoa.
Dude.
Okay, she's not as famous.
I'm gonna flip this over.
Dude, she's so good.
She's just. Pretty.
Right. You ever want to do bass line? You want to have some crazy bass lines? Let's do some Dua Lipa. Okay? They're grooving.
All right, I didn't look too much into Dua Lipa.
I know. I know you don't like pop music, but if you ever do, listen to Dua Lipa.
I'm just super selective when it comes to, like, with anything, to be honest.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah.
You're selective with your music?
Oh, completely, dude.
Interesting.
Yeah, you gotta be. A lot of Dua Lipa crap out there, you know what I mean?
Yeah, Joey's just throwing shade today. Bruce Springsteen.
Dua Lipa? What is he carrying in his back pocket? Jeez. What is that? A hat? A handkerchief? What are you doing? Get out of here. Wipe your head, throw it out. What have you been listening to?
Recently, a lot of electronic music. Boys of Canada are still pretty good. Mm-hmm. I think I mentioned them last
time. Still going strong on them?
Oh, yeah. No, you can't get enough.
Yeah.
No. They use a lot of like tape machines, and then they like they use tape and like slow it down, like cut the actual physical tape,
like,
and
it sounds analog, sick.
Oh yeah. And then you transform it into like MIDI or whatever, and it sounds great.
Dude, ever since you showed me your pedals, or like the Teenage Engineering, I've been looking up all this stuff, and they have like a recorder.
Yeah, yeah.
You saw that, and it's like you can kind of stop it.
Yeah, it's like
and
a tape machine.
Oh, it's so cool. Have you ever seen that?
No, I haven't.
Oh, it's great. You record something, and then, you know, it's just like a classic, like, tape recorder. Mm-hmm. And then, but it, as it's turning, you can kind of stop it and be like,
That's the thing. It says it looks like it's tape because it's got the spinny thing, but it's all digital.
Okay.
Oh, so it's just like, yeah, that's cool.
But it, like, it's like also like $600.
No, that's, dude, that's like $1,200. That's like,
at least. No.
I think it's like $1,500 or $1,600.
That's because they all sold out as soon as they got put on the market. Because, like, everything
so
they make is like,
though. That's why.
Like Apple. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like the, I don't know. They might be like like, because what Apple does, they like sell an experience, you know? So stuff's expensive. Hmm. So it's probably pretty overpriced, but it's like, they got like crazy engineers working on this stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's different from Apple because, like,
there's a lot of things you can do with it.
Yeah.
You know?
And, like, because, like, Apple, they sell phones. You can buy a phone somewhere else.
Yeah.
You can't buy an OP1 anywhere else.
That's
like,
true.
So that is true.
You can't buy little statues or, I mean, I guess you can buy a tape recorder somewhere else, but it won't be what that is.
Yeah. I don't get those statues. I mean, what is
the choir? You've never seen the choir video then? The OP1 OP1 choir?
I just told you. I watched all of them.
All of them? Dude,
I went down the Teenage Engineering, you know, line. I was looking at all
Teenage Engineering.
Teenage Engineering. That's a little underground take for you.
Yeah. Music tech company.
Not many people know about that.
Yeah, real underground.
Crazy stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Real top of the line stuff.
But,
but I don't know, these wooden statues, they're just.
Yeah, there's these like little guys that you can like put around in like a choir, and then you hook it up to your like little synthesizer, like one of those, and then you you press it, and it like sings. All of them like sing at once. It's like it's called a choir.
Yeah.
All right, get
choir
out.
Empire. I'm not into it, man. I'm not into those little wooden guys, you know?
Those are, like, they're probably expensive, too, and they're also, like, really niche. Like, you can't really use them for much.
Nah. Yeah, dude, they just sit there, like, you know? Like,
yeah, who needs those when we got Joey singing over here?
Exactly.
That's right.
What are we talking about?
We got
just layer.
Hello. It's going to be stuck in all your heads.
For the rest.
I don't know. Watch any movies lately?
Movies?
A few.
Not really.
I went on a trip with some of my friends, and they're really big movie guys. This guy, he's got like a whole list of things that we like. He wants us to watch in our life, which is hilarious. And he checks them off every time.
You know,
we
this guy, but then you sadly just realize no one's gonna ever watch anything you ask him to.
No, because that's the whole thing. It's like if you come at someone and you're like, I want you to watch this movie. I love this movie. You will love it.
Yeah,
like, that's automatically like -2 points.
Yeah, like now I'm really never gonna watch this movie. You know,
also ever. It's like feels like a chore when you have like a list of movies.
Well, here's the thing: if you gave me a movie to watch, I'd watch it.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
I'd watch. That's what they all say.
No, I would. I would, and would. And if it sucked, I'd call you right back. I'd be like, dude, why'd you waste 2 hours of my life? You know, like. Mm. But I'll watch it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And what it is that you expect that from the next person. You expect them to do as you would do.
Mm.
And when they don't, you just get like heartbroken. You're just like, I'm never gonna recommend another movie again.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah.
But also, like, a big list like that takes a lot of time.
Yeah, you don't throw a list at someone. Yeah. You throw one or two, and then you kind of,
If they like it, then you give them some more.
No, and you know, the people that make the list are the guys that watch the like 2-3 hour long movies.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, like, I'll watch that.
Speaking of like 3-hour long movies, did either of you guys see like Oppenheimer?
I did not.
No, I haven't seen it yet.
I want to.
I made the mistake of going at like a 9:30 show because I was like, oh, there's no seats anywhere.
It's like the sun's coming up.
And then I get out of the theater, I was like, man, this movie's taking forever. Like, I thought it was going to be like 2.5 hours. It was like 3 hours. I get out at like 12:40. I'm like,
wow.
No.
I love watching movies at night.
Yeah.
And I love long movies, but they just don't mix together at all.
I love a good day movie.
Day movies are nice, but especially if you like get out of there like 2.
Yeah.
It's like,
You plan it right, everything's good. You still got the whole day, you know, it's like.
I walk out and I feel like I'm waking up.
Yeah, you got the whole day to just think about the movie.
Nice, you know? Nice.
Then, so you saw Oppenheimer?
Yeah, yeah.
How was it?
It was pretty good. I mean,
Pretty good? Yeah, see, that's the thing.
Dude. It's like, I thought it was going to be like amazing. I was like really excited about like the science part. So like the first half was like, science. Mm-hmm.
Science.
It was pretty cool. And then it got into like politics.
Yeah,
and I was I don't care.
Oh, what the hell?
But yeah, I saw a review of it and it makes sense. Like, I saw some guy review it. He was like, most people went in thinking it was going to be about the bomb, but it's really about Oppenheimer.
Yeah.
And it's called Oppenheimer. And I was like, I mean, like, fair enough.
Makes
Can't
sense.
Be too critical. Yeah. But I don't know. It felt like 2 movies.
What about the Barbie movie? Seen that yet?
No.
Joe, you hate everything.
I hate everything.
Critics love it, man.
Yeah, people are eating it.
Yeah, people are saying that it's actually kind of deeper than they expected.
That's the whole point, right?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
I don't know. It's Barbie. What are you supposed?
Barbie like used to be super controversial the past, like, because it's like.
Yeah, how are we supposed to look like Barbie?
But then, like, I don't know, kind of. It's back.
Yeah, it's
Barbie's
a doll.
Back.
You're not supposed to look like the doll. It's when back. I had the wrestlers, I didn't go like. Well, I gotta look like that. I gotta look like that.
But yeah. I don't know.
What are we doing?
I feel like we got, during the pandemic, streaming services made everything like, I don't know. Because now in my mind, I want to go home and watch Oppenheimer.
Oh,
I don't
want
to go to the theater.
No.
I don't know. I love a good theater movie, man.
Me too, but there's a time and a place, and it's so expensive. Like, come on.
Yeah.
Like, tickets are expensive. Like, when I see it and I go in, it's like 3 hours and it's like, $18 for seat, like,
it's
on.
Something that if I'm gonna go to the movies, I'm like, I gotta wanna watch this movie.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just, you know, I wanna experience everything that the movie theater has.
Yeah.
You know, and yeah, otherwise I'm not,
yeah,
I'm not just going to the movies, you know.
Same with like music. I feel like that's how like music is supposed to be like experienced. There's like a big difference for me in like listening to something like on your phone versus like in the car, like all the way
completely.
At like 200%.
There is nothing more satisfying than making a beat or making a song and stuff like that, and then going into the car and just
cranking it,
chilling and just listening to it, you know, and just.
I'll just go sit in the car and play my music.
Yeah, because I used to like with different beats, like I would like pan it, so like, you know, it'd be like go to one side and go to the next, and that was the best part about listening into the car, is like. You hear it over there, and you hear it, and you're like, yeah, that's what I meant to do.
Well, I mean, professional musicians all the time.
Yeah.
They have to, like, especially, like, audio engineers, they have to mix stuff.
Right.
To, like, fit every situation. And you're actually not supposed to mix stuff with headphones because of the way it's panned.
Sure.
It's quieter if it's in the middle.
Hmm.
So all of these use speakers, but their studio speakers will sound different from car speakers than from laptop speakers.
Yeah, dude.
So they sit in the car, and like, I've heard stories
about the car's the best place.
Yeah.
People trying to finish mixes and like calling Ubers and like sitting in the Uber.
Really?
Like, yeah.
That's crazy.
That's so cool.
You gotta be rich for that.
I guess, yeah.
So that Uber driver just has to listen to your music the whole time?
I mean, it's probably like, I guess some like unreleased music that some like, well, probably not big time audio engineer, but like, some small time mixers.
What a funny little scene. We should do like a short little film of like, you know, some guy who just made a song and he's like calling the Uber.
Yeah, no
but
call.
The Uber guy keeps talking. You know, the guy.
Song.
He's like, all right, hey, just come on. Yeah. And he's like, oh, you know, he's like, and he's like, calls another Uber, and then he just spends the whole night just trying to get in Ubers, quiet Ubers.
Yeah.
That's what it's called, Quiet Uber.
Quiet Uber.
This is how they come up with like SNL skits.
Yeah.
Just Joey.
SNL,
Joey.
Get out of here.
That's why most of them are okay.
Get out of here, SNL.
Yeah, but I remember watching the Travis Scott documentary, and there was a scene where Travis Scott and Mike Dean were mixing stuff.
I saw that.
In his car. Like, yeah. He just went out to the driveway and sat in the car and mixed stuff.
I've done that before.
That's crazy, man. Like, you get way up to the top of the music career, you're still going in your car listening to the music.
Everyone listens to the music
in the car.
How it's so humble.
It has to be good.
Yeah. So wholesome and nice.
Well, yeah, because I mean, you gotta make music that sounds good, and speakers are like, there's such a wide range.
So yeah.
You gotta make sure it sounds good on everything. So.
That's so true.
No, that's the problem I have. Like, as soon as you, like, make a track and then you export it to Google Drive, it just goes... It sounds awful.
Really?
You've got to, like, remix it again.
Yeah, pretty much. Mixing is, like, it's really tedious, but it's so important.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It, like, separates the amateurs from the pros, like, literally.
I don't mind that process, that part of the process. Yeah.
I don't hate it, but when it's...
I mean, it can leave you cross-eyed, and it can kind of, like, tunnel vision you into a way where you're, like... I don't even know what I'm listening to anymore.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just, but I do like that part.
Well, it's kind of a joke among like producers where it's like you like edit like settings of a plugin and you realize it's off and that stuff like that. And like, or like when I'm like sitting there, I like my tracks and I'm adjusting volumes to mix it properly. I'm like, is it better? I can't tell.
No.
Like I don't, it's such an art. It's
yeah.
An art. And there are people who are really good at it.
Yeah.
And I don't know. The worst thing is actually when I export stuff and I realize the mix sucks. And
yeah.
I export it again. I have all these files with the same name. I'm like, which one's the best
one? Oh. You got to go through all those.
Yeah. But then I figure out. I just listen to it.
Yeah.
But.
Good advice. You want to make music? Listen to it.
Listen to it.
Yeah. Over and over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
Or don't. And just release it to the world.
Yeah, or don't. Yeah.
Whatever works.
So.
But yeah, what else we got? We got anything else?
No. We already know Seamus' opinion on water. So,
Well, maybe he's changed it.
On faucet water? I still drink faucet water, guys.
Still drinking the faucet water,
every
huh?
Every once in a while. If I'm, like, running late. Because I've got fridge water. If I'm running late for, like...
Fridge water.
Practice or something, I'll just grab my water bottle, like...
I will say, the faucet fills faster than the fridge water.
It does.
You push a button, it's like a... I mean, it comes out, but like... I can just go smack it all the way up, the faucet. Full pressure.
Yeah.
5 seconds flat is full.
This is ridiculous. All right, I lost today with the water. It was two against one. I did not lose every time. You know?
Don't want to speak badly of our guests, but if they ever come on here saying bottled water is better, then...
Yeah, I don't know about that one.
Oh, we'll see about
that.
It's a bit
of a stretch.
We'll see about that. It's gonna be a. I don't know where I was going with that. Okay. So. All right. Yeah, I mean, I don't think we got anything else. You got anything to add?
Nah, we've been talking way too long. We got our boy Zach gonna read some poetry.
We're
about to do some ambient jams. Looking forward to this one.
Yeah, it's gonna be a fun one.
Yeah.
I hope you guys enjoyed On the Spot Season 1. Stay tuned for the future. We don't know what it holds, but it holds something. That's for sure.
No.
Yeah, like bottled water.
God, I hope not. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy. And bye! Thank you.
I was at a bar Saturday night, or wasn't I? No one really acknowledged my presence, not even the bartender, who chopped limes all night. So it was hard to tell if I was just a ghost. The rain pummeled the parking lot that night. I remember it well. Black skies had flashed white lightning, like electrocuted skeletons on fire. Thunder bowled psychotically through the sky. Still no drink. "Hey, did I miss last call?" I said. Bartender hobbling over. "No, what do you like?" he says. His face a droopy-eyed zombie mask. "I would like to drink," my eyes wide. Right palm on right cheek. "Say, who's the big cheese around here?" I demand, not unkindly, but with a glassy, delicate frustration. "You're looking at him." "Oh, I see. Well, tell me, Mr. Hinckley. Gabe Hinckley." Mr. Hinckley, do you get many people like me who like to drink? Mr. Hinckley, the bartender, hunches over the bar counter, arms crossed defensively, wishing the lightning had struck me out. I can't say I've ever seen your kind in here before. He stares at me like I'm a murderer. The sentiment is mutual, but I don't tell him. Instead, I slap my hand on the bar and then walk out with a facilitatory smile.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.